Qing Dynasty Emperor Kangxi loved wrestling. In fact, at his instruction, the best wrestlers were recruited to form a wrestling battalion called Shan Pu Ying, and he always took this performance battalion with him on his inspection tours. Every year, Emperor Kangxi presided over a wrestling competition in his summer resort in Chengde, close to Beijing. During the autumn hunting season, he would watch a grand performance by the best wrestlers in his battalion, and the highlight was always the confrontation with the Mongolian wrestlers. At the beginning, the Manchu wrestlers seldom won in competition against the Mongolian wrestlers, but after the wrestling battalion was established, considerable effort went into the training of the Manchu wrestlers. As a result, by the time of the reign of Emperor Qianlong, they were every bit as good as the Mongolians. Beginning from the reign of Emperor Qianlong, there were virtually no wars, and the function of the wrestling battalion switched from battle skill training to entertainment for the emperor on ceremonial occasions.
就是八旗这个各个营要选派这个年轻有为的弟子可造就之才送到善蒲营去培训三年结业满了以后回到你那个旗去做教官这个呢在清史档案上
With the downfall of the Qing Dynasty in 1911, the wrestling battalion was disbanded and all its members became ordinary citizens. Without government salaries, they had no income. Yet, while entertainers in other genres were reaching out to the general public to make a living, these wrestlers with their extraordinary skills simply refused to follow suit. The way they saw it, their skills were for the emperor only, and performing for commoners was shameful. It seemed that wrestling, as a time-tested sport and form of entertainment, was set to die out. Then, 2 years after the downfall of the Qing Dynasty, in Hongmiao, Beijing, a former top-ranking wrestler from the battalion by the name of Wan Yongxun set up a private wrestling workshop. His new establishment marked wrestling stepping down from its elevated imperial position, and many of the students he mentored went on to become famous wrestlers among Beijing's general public.
As a public entertainment, wrestling needed appropriate venues where people could gather to watch. The comic wrestling at the beginning of our program today mentioned a venue. That was Tianqiao, a place where various forms of entertainment flourished in the early 20th century, wrestling included.
Between Yongding Gate and Jiangyang Gate in the southern part of Beijing was Tianqiao, the only road leading to the city from the south. Before the Qing Dynasty came to its end, a large number of peddlers made a living there selling food and small items of merchandise, and it was very much a place for people from the lower strata of society. But by the time of the reign of Emperor Guangxu, Tianqiao became a much busier place due to the completion of the Beijing-Wuhan Railway and the railway station built just outside Yongding Gate. The reason was simple. All merchants and travellers had to pass this place before they reached Beijing, and so entertainment businesses were established to cater to them. These entertainment venues prospered, with every form of traditional entertainment being made available.
Later, people called this Tianqiao, not to use it as a land name, but to use it as a community artist's gathering place, a performance space. Beijing's Tianqiao 和天津的三不管、南京的夫子庙，这都是当地民间艺人的一个， 非常著名的一个演艺的场所，天桥五行八作，主要是民间艺人打把式卖艺的，曲艺艺人在这地方比较多，所以呢，这个名声很大。
In 1927, a wrestling ground appeared in the western part of Tianqiao. Its owner, just 24 years of age, was Mao Shanli. But as he was the third child in the family, he was generally known by the more intimate name Bao the Third. Bao San, or Bao the Third, had learnt martial arts when very young, and later he'd become a student of Yuan Yongxun in Hongliang.In his book, Miscellaneous Notes About Folk Art Forms, well-known storyteller Lian Kuo Ru wrote the following. Wrestling was about to disappear in the early years of the Republic, but thanks to a group of wrestlers performing it in the streets, the form survived. Although they made a living in a humble way in the same way as performers of other forms, they were accorded more respect than the others.
是比如像一些个交手呢，到民间去摔跤呢，也不会收钱，也不会打钱。这个打钱呢，还是后来的一些个人教他们的，说你这样不行，你说人不给钱，人都一是吧，摔完了一散了，你跟谁要钱呢？你得有一些什么什么什么是吧，这个保坑的这招法，保坑嘛，你吃饭嘛。
To make a living, these wrestlers had to learn the trick of exactly how to attract spectators and how to get money out of their pockets. Later, these tricks became part of a set of standard practices for wrestling performers in the streets.
This is a business. This, 在座的人来着了。这位是帮忙的，分了不取，好了不要，连文连霸，跟大家求把钱，带着风文富裕，扔个一毛两毛的，没带钱，您白吃白看。一句话没，哪句话骂街损人，您进场克服大家，不叫您只叫无德，那算哥儿几个没受过学习。你这话多好，哎，给扔头把钱的鞠个躬。这时候。你看这打钱的，一要钱的时候，这人不走了，怎么也得往出掏。
After the appearance of Bao San's ground in Tianqiao, others sprung up as well, but none could match Bao San's ground in terms of fame. Bao San's was also the longest in business, lasting all the way up until the Cultural Revolution, which began in 1966.
一开始的时候啊，就是有几个板凳圈一圈，是吧？练完了以后摔跤，一般来说摔三跤，是吧？摔三跤，三跤两胜，是吧？摔三跤两胜，摔完了以后跟大家要钱。
It was the boss of the ground who decided who would wrestle whom before a performance began, and this was known as giving a job.
我给你混着打表演，就是不真摔，我给你表演，还表演出这个动作来呢，还不能让观众看出来你是在表演，这个难度就是说我做的这个动作还得特别好看，还得摔在地还得起得高，叫你看着舒服，你才愿意掏这钱啊。
真摔它不好看啊，你真摔咱俩死掐，你不让我不让你啊，都这么样。杵着是谁输了不成的比赛赛的真的。你如果你比到比赛这你是打不下钱了呀。真摔你是跟谁要钱去，俩人那么掐着蹲当骑马是什么不见交。打不下钱了。
预备开始。
好小的和。
这一搓。你越抬腿这个腿你越抬我越跟着你。这出一个弄就这样啪一塞
Today, this traditional sport of wrestling enjoys tremendous popularity. Numerous lovers of the sport come to this wrestling club to hone their skills and meet like-minded friends.
好听，你这顺来了，顺踢呢，啊，往这边让，啊，这才能来呢，知道吧？啊，这不是，啊，你算这把手一样，这不是，往这儿上，往上，骗足了，这才能来呢，别往后坐腰。
开始。
Sometimes famous wrestlers gather here to compare notes.Unlike traditional martial arts, which emphasize precise sets of regular moves, Chinese-style wrestling has no regular sets. The skills are employed according to the circumstances.
好，这叫手别，右手别。
它本身这个，我就追吧，这追出去了以后，拉过来以后，必须到这种角度，然后这才能别背部。这儿不背部，别不过去。背部，哎，背部，哎，你看这多顺的。
Unlike wrestling styles found in other parts of the world, Chinese style wrestling emphasizes knocking an opponent over without giving him an injury. With the exception of the feet, a participant loses when any part of his body touches the ground.Because of this rule, serious body injuries are unlikely, and this is one reason why so many favor the sport. As well as this, many of the skills in Chinese-style wrestling are truly ancient, having been passed down from one generation to another for thousands of years.
让我
了，
你走，
好，
摔跤 or Chinese-style wrestling has been transformed almost beyond recognition since its birth 2,000 years ago, outwardly at least. Yet it remains at heart simply a trial of strength and technique between two men. And in the course of its long history, Chinese wrestling has produced some remarkable characters whose stories have enriched the sport to the extent that it appeals to the far wider audience.Thank you for staying with us on today's New Frontiers. I'm Ji Xiaojun from CCTV International. Bye for now.